Good morning. Yeah, blessed morning. Everyone, I praise God that we are here together worshiping God with freedom and gladness in our hearts. If you are blessed kanina sa pag-aawitan, can you say amen?
Yeah.
Yeah. We miss Tita Lucille, 4 months. Nag-alaga ng apo. So 4 months. Talagang every time si Tita Lucille po ay nagli-lead ng worship through music, I am personally blessed on how she really lead the congregation para sa pagpupuri ng Panginoon. Amen? Amen. Again, blessed morning everyone. So pakisabi sa iyong katabi, blessed Sunday sa'yo. Okay. I would like to start this morning with a story. I remember a story of a five, let's say magbabarkada, limang kalalakihan na sila po ay nasa plane. Nung sila ay nasa plane, sila po ay, of course, may pupuntahan. May bigla po nagsabi, Mayday, Mayday, Mayday. So yung po yung nagsabi doon is yung pilot. So yung limang kalalakihan na yon is isa yung pilot, yung isa doctor, yung isa lawyer, yung isa pastor, yung isa is a young man. So may merong, ulitin ko po ulit, pilot, lawyer, doctor, pastor, na young man. So sabi nung pag-isabi ng pilot, Mayday, 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 sabi niya, meron tayong 4 na parachutes dyan. So mag-crash na yung plane, bahala na kayo kung sino ang ititira nyo, ililigtas nyo. Sabay talon nung pilot at siya ang naiwan po ay 4 na kalalakihan. So sumunod, sabi nung doctor, sabi niya, naku, dapat ako kasi ako yung doctor. Sa akin yung isang parachute kasi yung aking reputation, yung aking responsibility is important kumpara sa inyo. Kasi mas marami akong matutulungan. So kuha ng parachute, then tumalon. So ilan na natira? 3 sila with 2 parachutes. Now, sabi ng lawyer, siya yung una, sabi niya, ako ang pinaka matalinong tao sa mundo. Marami akong naipanalong tawag dito, mga cases. I am the smartest guy dito sa plane na to. So I deserve to be saved. So kinuha niya yung bag, parachute, sabay talon. So ilan na lang natitira? Isang pastor at a young boy. Of course, ang pastor, eh, alam naman natin, most of the heart of the pastors ay talagang sacrificial. Okay? So sabi niya sa young man, don't worry young man. Sa'yo na yung parachute. Fulfill ko na yung aking mission dito sa earth. Okay na akong mamatay at makakapiling ang Panginoon. So pagkasabi niya yun, sabi ng young man sa kanya, ningitian siya. Sabi niya, relax lang pastor, don't worry. The smartest guy in the world, eh bago siya tumalon, kinuha niya yung backpack ko. So ang natira kaming dalawa. Okay. Well, the moral lesson of the story is makikita natin sa Proverbs 16, pride goes before destruction. So seemingly, yung kwento ay parang ano no, pero in reality, kung titignan natin, we can identify doon sa mga taong yun na if we want to be saved doon sa situation that we are in, we are entitled doon sa mga achievements natin, yung ating mga tawag dito, yung mga na-achieve natin sa buhay. Okay? So, now, we are in the series of discussing our theme for this month. Ano yung theme natin for 2 months? Rooted in service. So, last 3 Sundays ago, Elder Cito Silva talked about the topic, we serve with the same master. So, meaning to say, kahit nasaan ka, if anak ka ng Panginoon, ang mindset po natin dapat ay ang ating pinaglilingkuran ay sino? This is Jesus Christ. Then after that, 2 weeks ago, Bishop F. Tendero talked about the topic, we serve with the same body. So meaning to say, we are all one in body of Christ. Bawat isa po sa atin ay importante at bawat isa sa atin ay may role sa kaharian ng Panginoon. Pakisabi sa yung katabi, you are important. Sige po, yeah. You are important. And last Sunday, we have, you know, that privilege to honor our fathers. Diba? So we thank God for our fathers who sacrifice a lot for our families. Someday, ako po ay magiging tatay, definitely. So, ilang, happy Father's Day. Advance sa akin. Okay, anyway. Now, this morning, we will talk about the topic, we serve with the same virtue. We serve with the same virtue. So, ang text natin This can be found in the book of Philippians chapter 2 verses 1 to 11. Salamat Elder Mon for reading the message. I entitled the message this morning, Greatest Example of Humility. So let's look at the passage. I want to break this down into two parts. First, in verses of 1 to 4, Apostle Paul gives us the principles of what he wants us to apply in our daily lives. Then second, in verses 5 to 11, Apostle Paul gives us the picture on how Jesus Christ applied these principles when he lived here on earth. So nakikita po natin yung principles and picture. Yun po yung pag-uusapan at pag-aaralan natin ngayong umaga. But first, let's take a look. Ano ba yung mga purposes why Paul wrote this letter to the Philippians? Tignan natin. Number one, to thank the Philippians for the gift they had sent him upon learning of his detention at Rome. Alam naman natin na ang si Apostle Paul, ang konteksto nito ay siya po ay nabilanggo. Second, to report about his own circumstances. Third, to encourage the Philippians to stand firm in the face of persecution and rejoice regardless of circumstances. So alam po natin ang episode po ng joy, I mean ang episode po ng Philippians ay joy episode. Yan po yung kanyang theme. Next, to exhort humility and unity to them. There appears to have some discord, meaning to say conflict and division in the church. Makikita po natin yan sa chapter 4 na nagkaroon ng hindi pag-uunawaan doon. Then next, to commend Timothy and Epaphroditus to the Philippian church. And lastly, to warn the Philippians against Judaizers, legalists. When we say legalists and Judaizers, ito po yung mga followers, strict followers of the law of Moses, ng Old Testament. And to warn the Philippians against negative teaching and false teachers. So now, let's go to chapter 2, kung saan po diniscuss ni Apostle Paul yung humility. Philippians chapter 2 verses 1 to 2. Therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from His love, if any common sharing in the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and of one mind. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, you have to value others above yourselves, not looking to your own interest, but each of you to the interest of others. Oh, praise God for that words. Yeah. In these verses, makikita po natin, Paul gives us the principles that we can follow to apply towards serving others. He presents 4 attitudes that can help us understand the true meaning of humility. Ano po ba yung apat na ito? Ito yung bibigyan natin ng emphasis. First, a humble person, makikita niyo po yan sa inyong bulletin, a humble person is not selfish. It's not selfish. Sabi doon sa Philippians 2 chapter 3, do nothing out of selfish ambition. What is selfish ambition? Selfish ambition can be understood as a motivation to elevate oneself or to put one's interest before another's interest. It is a self above others approach. So meaning to say, when we do things for God, don't do it out of selfish motive and ambition. So a humble person is not selfish. A humble person is not self-centered. So let's take note of that. A humble person is not selfish. Next, a humble person is not prideful. Philippians chapter 2 verse 3, do nothing out of vain conceit. Ano bang ibig sabihin pag vain conceit? Vain conceit means excessive pride or self-esteem that has no foundation in reality. It is an elevated and incorrect sense of self. So, tignan po natin yung paragraph na yan. If you are always boasting and can stop talking about yourself, you have that character flaw known as conceit. Your friends, if you have any, may also complain about your arrogance, vanity, and egotism. Pag-isipan po natin. Nakaka-identify po ba tayo dito sa passage? Or meron bang pumapasok sa inyong isip na someone na parang kapag kayo nag-uusap, eh, hindi ka pa tapos, bigla na lang sisingit at binibida yung kanyang sarili. Bida-bida, kumbaga tawagin natin. Actually, marami yan. Marami po tayo yan. Of course, hindi tayo exempted dun sa part na yun. Yung tipong pinagmamalaki yung mga achievements sa buhay in a subtle way. Ah, parang ako, ganito. Ito ka lang. So, a humble person is not prideful. So, do nothing out of vain conceit means not letting our actions be motivated by selfishness and pride. A humble person does not seek glory for himself. Diba meron tayong tinatawag na glory be to me. Pag yung tipong nakapagtapos tayo ng isang, naka-accomplish tayo ng isang bagay, nagawa natin yung bagay ng maganda, sarap ng feeling. Sobrang sarap ng feeling. Especially kapag, alam mo talaga, pinupuri ka ng tao. So ikaw ay para kang lumulutang. At mapalakpak ang yung tenga at lumalaki yung ulo. So again, Paul reminded us na a humble person is not prideful. So next, a humble person is not only selfish and prideful, a humble person sees great value on others. A humble person always thinking of others as better than himself. Why? Because ang tingin niya sa mga tao ay mahalaga. If you remember yung message po ni Bishop F about yung ang bawat isa sa atin sa body of Christ ay importante. Naalala niyo po yung message na yun? Well, actually, that is true. We have to remember that each and every one of us here is valuable in the body of Christ. Minsan, ito, this is the reality. I don't know if sa inyo, pero po sa akin, personal, may mga pagkakataon po sa buhay na kung paano tayo mag-treat ng ibang tao ay depende sa kanyang, minsan, pananamit, minsan sa kanyang the way kanya tratuhin din. Diba sometimes kapag yung treatment mo sa general, pagdating sa guard, eh iba. Kasi of course, general, mas mataas yan eh. Pero kapag dating minsan sa mga maintenance, sa mga guard, sa mga janitor, meron tayong tendency to treat them na pas parang mababa sa atin. If you admit, tanggapin man natin o hindi, pero meron ganong pagkakataon sa buhay natin na na-experience natin yun. So we have to remember that in the body of Christ, we are all equal. We are all valuable. A humble person sees great value on others. Again, all of us are important and all of us has a role in the body of Christ. Next, a humble person is looking in the interest of others. Do not look out only for their own interests, but take an interest in others too. Philippians 2 chapter 4. They balance the need of others with their own needs. I remember, yung experience po namin ng aking missis, we have this, Nicole, parang kasunduan na after po namin kumain ng sa fast food or sa restaurant, ang gagawin po namin is to clean up the table and tulungan, in a sense, yung mga nagliligpit. Have you done? Nagawa nyo na po ba yun? Ay, meron. Okay. Di ba? Kasi yung feeling is, kapag nagagawa mo yun is a humbling experience. Why? Kasi ang aming pong mindset is itong mga taong to ay lalo na kapag rush hour, lalo na kapag ang daming tao, hirap na hirap sila, kitang-kita mo, hindi magkanda o gaga kung saan pupunta, kung paano nila pagsasabayin yung kanilang mga ginagawa. So in that manner, nakakatulong kami dun sa mga taong yun. It's like that, it's looking in the interest of others. Meaning to say, tinitignan po namin yung mga taong yun na mahalaga rin. So I challenge you. Siguro kapag kayo po ay kumain, try nyo lang pong subukan na after nyo kumain, ligpitin mo lang, ano bang tawag doon, isang kalan ng maayos. napaka, yung experience yun is really humbling. Diba kapag inuuna natin ang interest ng ibang tao, ma-avoid po natin na mas bigyang importansya at halaga ang ating sarili. So ano po uli yung mga principles na binanggit ni Apostle Paul sa atin? A humble person is not selfish, is not prideful, sees great value on others, and is looking in the interest of others. Actually, in Philippians chapter 2, verses 1 to 2, Paul writes, "Therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from His love, if any common sharing in the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and one in mind." Ito po yung basis of our being like-minded and less conflict in the body of Christ. Base po yan dun sa binasa natin na Philippians chapter 2 verses 1 to 2. Sabi doon, we are united with Christ. We are comforted with God's love. We have the same spirit. We have been given tender compassion for others. So ito yung nagiging basis natin para yung pagiging isa ng pag-iisip at yung parang less yung conflict sa body of Christ, ito yung pinagkaloob sa atin ng Panginoon. Now, it is true that the understanding of our salvation, our relationship with God, that we can live with in unity with other believers and love them with Christ. Do you agree? Yung pagkaintindi po natin sa relasyon natin sa Panginoon, sa pag-ibig niya, ito yung magko-compel sa atin para mahalin natin yung mga kapwa mananampalataya natin. So the basis, ito pong pinagkaloob sa atin ng Panginoon. When we truly see how much Christ has done for us and understand the fullness of His love, pride and selfishness will melt away. Those who know the love of Christ do not argue for the position within the family of God. Rather, they recognize the purpose of the body of Christ and live it out. They are willing to take the lower position or place in order to serve others. They engage in Christian fellowship with a focus on loving God and others. So madaling salita, to be humble, basically we need to move away from self to others. From self to others, pursuing lowliness and helpfulness. So kung lahat tayong mananampalataya ay kikilos at nag-iisip ng ganito, ang bawat isa po sa atin ay maaalagaan natin at mapaglilingkuran natin ayon sa kalooban ng Panginoong Hesukristo. Pwede po bang pakisabi sa inyong katabi, I love you with the love of the Lord. Amen. So those are the principles that Paul wants us to apply in our daily lives. So kanina, principle. Now let's go to the next part of this. Itong next part. Sabi po sa verses 5 to 11, basahin ko po siya. In your relationships with one another, have the same mindset of Christ Jesus, who, being in the very nature of God, did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on the cross. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Very powerful the passage po yan. And these verses are passage, ito po yung picture na gustong ipakita sa atin ni Paul. A picture that yung picture of humility, the greatest example of humility. Paul mentioned about the mindset of Jesus Christ. So let's talk about the mindset of Jesus Christ na binabanggit ni Apostle Paul dito sa mga passages na to. The mind of Christ. So, ano yung mind or mindset of Jesus Christ that we need to apply whether with our family members, co-workers, church members, or anyone that we are in relationship with, or yung people we encounter. Sabi po dito sa Philippians 2, verses 6 to 7, dito po first makikita yun is yung who being very nature of God did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage, rather he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness. So the first picture na pinapakita dito is yung willing to sacrifice, or yung willingness to sacrifice. Why? Because when we think of Jesus Christ, imagine po natin yung picture na yun, that he has a perfect setup sa heaven. There's no pain, there's no sorrow, there's no difficulties. The angels are worshiping him and everyone in heaven are worshiping him there. Pero anong ginawa niya? Bumaba siya dito sa atin para po sa ating kapakanan, para sa ating mga makasalanan. Now the question is, if you say you want to be like Jesus Christ, or should I ask, sino po dito yung gustong maging katulad ni Jesus Christ? Can you raise your hand? And if you are saying that you want to be Jesus Christ, or you want to serve God in His kingdom, what are you willing to sacrifice for Him? Ano yung pwede nating isakripisyo para sa ating Panginoong Hesukristo? Are you willing to sacrifice and give the things that are valuable to you for God or for those you are in relationship with? Willing po ba tayong isacrifice yung mga bagay na yun? Like yung time, yung money, yung position, relationships, yes, relationships, even yung lahat ng mahalagang bagay sa atin sa buhay natin. Are we willing to sacrifice yung mga bagay na yun? Willingness to sacrifice na pinakita sa atin ng ating Panginoon. So the first mindset is willingness to sacrifice. Yung second mindset that Paul saying that we need to apply in our lives, and if we are saying that we are going to be like Christ, is not only willing to be sacrificial, but also the willingness to be a servant. Tignan po natin, who being in the very nature of God did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness. So the second picture is yung willing to be a servant, or yung willingness to be a servant. So imagine, from sacrifice, bumaba po siya to being a servant. Tignan po natin. Notice what Paul says here in verse 7. Ito po yung binigyan ko kaninang emphasis. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant. So now we see, yun nga, Jesus taking another step down in terms of humility from sacrificing to serving. In a sense, Jesus Christ did not come to earth to be a king, but rather, every time we see Jesus, He is in the position of a servant. Kung titignan po natin yung buhay ni Kristo, laging ang Diyos natin ay naglilingkod sa Kanyang mga tao. Jesus is serving people. He's washing people's feet. He's feeding people. He raised people from the dead. He's teaching people. He's healing people and doing miracles. Yun po yung ministry ng Panginoon sa atin eh. Service. So the question that we need to ask or challenge ourselves is, am I the type of person ba na gustong laging pinagsisilbihan? Try to analyze. Ikaw ba yung tao o tayo po ba yung tao na gustong laging pinagsisilbihan? Or ikaw yung tao na talagang kapag naglilingkod sa iyong kapo ay talagang nagagalak ang iyong puso? Try to analyze yung the way we live now. How much are we willing to serve? I mean, how much are we willing to serve others with humility sa kaharian ng Panginoon? So first mindset, ano po yung first mindset? Sacrifice, willing to sacrifice. Next, willing to serve, willing to be servant. The third mindset that Paul says that we need to apply if we are saying that we are going to be like Christ is that the idea of submission. Yung willingness to submit or willing to submit. Notice here in verse 8, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. Didignan po natin, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death. God the Son, which is Jesus Christ, is obedient to the will of God the Father. So he submitted to the Father. So again, we see that Jesus Christ is taking another step down towards humility from sacrificing, serving, and then, ano po yung sunod? Submitting or willingness to submit. In a sense, that before Jesus Christ even ever got to earth, bago siya bumaba dito, he first have to be willing to be submissive to the God, the Father. And he did. Remember that Jesus Christ was much God as God the Father, and yet this assignment, he is willing to surrender and submit his will in exchange for the will of the Father. So the question that we need to ask ourselves is, how much am I willing to submit? Or how submissive am I willing in terms of my relationship with others? Whether with your husband, with your wife, with co-workers at church, leadership, or even sa government? Or am I the type of person that always need to be in control and having other people submit to me? So willing to sacrifice, willing to serve, and willing to submit. Now, this fourth and last mindset is probably not yung one that we're going to like, kasi hindi to masyadong gusto yung idea ng sinasabi dito ni Apostle Paul. Ano yung idea na yun? Yung suffering. Yung willing to suffer. Diba kapag suffering, medyo ano tayo dyan eh? Ilag. So I want you to notice that on the previous verse, sa verse 8, Paul says here, and being found in the appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. So the idea and picture na pinapakita dito ni Apostle Paul is that Jesus was willing to suffer and go to some difficulties and tribulation so that we can inherit, receive eternal life and salvation. You agree with me dun sa idea po na yun? Bumaba si Kristo dito para po sa atin, nag-suffer siya for our sake. Now, there's this idea po and belief that really, you know, frustrates me. Actually, nalulungkot po ako. Kasi ito po yung doctrine na some of the believers, or should I say, quote-unquote, false doctrine na sinusunod ng mga mananampalataya ng Panginoon. That when we accept Christ, that the Christian life, kapag tinanggap mo ang Panginoong Hesukristo, na inyong Diyos at tagapagligtas, ang buhay daw natin ay supposed to be easy, perfect, at walang flaw. Actually, meron ganun na namumuhay na once na tinanggap ko ang Panginoon, wala na akong problema sa buhay. Perfect health, wealth, and everything in life supposed to be working out perfectly. Now, whenever we look at the life of Jesus, we can see that it is the exact opposite. Jesus was in pain, he was struggling, he was going through difficult times, and ultimately, Jesus Christ had to be willing to suffer. Kung yung titignan po natin yung buhay ng Panginoong Hesukristo dito, talagang nag-suffer po siya. So the question that we need to ask or challenge ourselves if we say that we are willing to be like Jesus Christ is, how willing are we to suffer for the gospel and with our relationship with others in serving them in the kingdom of God? So are you willing to suffer when it comes to serving ang ating mga kapatid, even ang pagsunod sa ating Panginoong Hesukristo? So again, what does it mean to have the mindset or mind of Jesus Christ? Number one, willing to sacrifice, willing to be a servant, willing to submit, and willing to suffer. But we have to take note that there is blessing doon po sa last verses, sa 9 to 11 na passage. The blessing in this passage is that because Jesus Christ was willing to humble himself, ano po ginawa ng Panginoon? God exalted him. Basahin po natin. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Now, the blessing is that if we follow Jesus Christ's example, if He, God, exalted Jesus Christ, time will come. If we'll do the same, God will do the same for you and for me. So what a great lesson for us to learn. Humility equals blessing. Now, this is the challenge. So, pinag-usapan natin yung principle and picture ng humility. Nung ako po yung nagpe-prepare ng message, meron po akong time na na-encounter kami po ng aking asawa na tinanong po niya sa akin, how do I know when I've arrived in humility? Paano ko malalaman na humble na ako? So, paano mo malalaman na ikaw ay humble? Natatawa po kayo siguro. Kasi, well, that's the point. That's the thing about humility. Because when you think you have, actually, you haven't. Right? Humility is that the thing that the day you think you have humility, that's the day and time you lost it. So, pag sinasabi mong humble ka, eh, hindi ka talaga humble. So, meron ang saying, the best way, in the picture and context of humility, the best way to go up is to go down. And if you want to go down, the best way is to go up. Kung gusto mong mapunta sa top, I mean, in the aspect of humility, you have to be humble. Reality check. Another thing. I know there are times that we experience, you know, challenges in our service with God by serving other people. Tama po ba? Ang hirap din minsan na kapag ikaw ay naglilingkod sa Panginoon, eh nagkakaroon ng mga sabihin nating samaan ng loob. Sometimes, ang nakakalungkot kung sino pa yung nasa kaharian ng Panginoon, nasa ministry, doon pa, seemingly, doon pa mas madalas yung tampuhan, kumparahan, minsan umaabot pa sa siraan, bakstaban, at bangayan. This is the sad reality in our churches even before pa up to now. But remember, brothers and sisters in the Lord, if we apply these principles and truths about the idea of rooted in service, yung pinag-usapan po natin for the 2 months, well, this month, yung that we serve with the same master, we serve with the same body, and we serve with the same virtue, which is humility, God will bring humility and improve unity. Meaning to say, the result of unity is the result of humility. Unity is the result of humility. Siguro po, in conclusion, gusto ko lang magbigay ng challenge sa bawat isa po sa atin. Mamaya po magkakaroon ng core of leaders election. Yung leaders po sa susunod na mga, ay sa church po natin dito sa KBCF, may mga bagong liderato. At the same time, may mga pag-uusapan dun. I do hope and pray na yung mga truths, yung mga principles that we studied here during Sunday, not only in Sunday, even yung mga cell group, lahat. Kasi meron po tayong discussion questions po dyan na pwedeng pag-usapan ng mga cell leaders and even the cell members. I do hope and pray na as we serve one another, yung picture na pinakita ni Jesus Christ nung bumaba po siya dito, which is yung humility, I do hope and pray na yun yung i-keep natin in mind. Not only for the leaders of this church, but even sa mga members, sa lahat po sa atin, yung the greatest example of humility, yung po sana yung mag-motivate sa atin to serve one another. Mahirap maging humble. Mas madali maging hambog. I do believe na ang bawat isa sa atin ay nakaka-relate doon. Mahirap mag-serve with humility. But of course, with the grace, with the love, with the pattern na pinakita sa atin ng Panginoon, mahirap siya, but hindi siya imposible. It is not impossible. So as we serve one another, as we serve God in the ministry, let's take the pattern and the picture na pinakita ni Apostle Paul, yung principles and the picture doon sa Book of Philippians. I do hope and pray that the lessons and principles and examples that we heard today will serve as a guide in our daily Christian life. Let's serve one another in humility as our Christ Jesus did. Join me in prayer. Lord God, we thank you, Father, for the principles, the picture, the truths about humility, Panginoon. You are the greatest example of humility, Father. We know, Father, na hindi ganun kadali na maglingkod sa inyo kung dahil lang sa aming kakayahan. But Lord, with your love, with your guidance, with your grace, we know na makakayanan po namin ito. And again, as we serve you, serve one another, help us, Panginoon, na instill sa mind and sa hearts po namin yung idea of we serve with the same virtue, which is humility. And we pray, Father, na we are rooted in you in serving one another. This is our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.